Welcome. Have you ever wondered how scientists, companies, or even doctors test a claim using data? It all comes down to hypothesis testing. Think of it like being a detective. Someone makes a claim, you collect evidence, and then you decide. Is the evidence strong enough to reject the claim, or should you let it stand? That's all hypothesis testing is. A formal procedure to check if a belief or claim is likely true using sample data. Let's use a clear example. Suppose a local belief is that the average age of College A students is 23. We want to investigate this claim. In statistics, we set up two opposing statements. The first is the null hypothesis H0. This is the default, the status quo. The claim we assume is true until proven otherwise. For this claim, the null hypothesis would be that the average age in the population is 23. That is, nothing interesting is happening or the default claim is correct. On the other hand, we have the alternative hypothesis H1 or HA. This is the opposite idea. The thing we suspect or we're trying to find evidence for. In this case, it could be that the average age is not 23. This indicates something different is happening or that the default claim is wrong. Now, we don't have access to every student at the college, so we take a random sample, say 50 students, and calculate their sample average age, X bar. This sample average is our evidence. We then ask the crucial question. Is a sample result close enough to 23 for us not to reject the original claim? Suppose the sample average is 22.8. That's pretty close to 23. It could easily be due to random chance. You will likely not reject the null hypothesis in that case. But if our sample average is 29.4, which is quite far off, we'll think, how can the entire college's average be 23 when our representative sample is this far away? In hypothesis testing, we usually don't draw conclusions based simply on the sample average. This brings us to the formal decision process. We set up some cutoff value called a critical value, or use a measure called the p-value. The value tells us if the null hypothesis were actually true, how likely is it that we would get the sample result as extreme as the one we got? We compare this probability to a significance level, usually 5% or 0.05, which is our cutoff for what we consider too unlikely. There are two possible scenarios we face. Scenario 1, a high p-value, that is a p-value greater than 0.05. This means the evidence, our sample, is consistent with the null hypothesis claim. Our decision would be to fail to reject the null hypothesis. We then conclude that we cannot disprove the claim that the average age might be 23. Note that we don't actually have a true way of proving that the average age is 23. We can only conclude that we cannot disprove the claim because we don't have sufficient evidence. We cannot prove that the average age is 23. Scenario 2. We could also obtain a low p-value or p-value less than 0.05. This means our sample, the evidence, is too unlikely to have occurred if the null hypothesis claim were true. So we reject the null hypothesis and conclude that the average age is probably not 23. This result is called statistically significant. That is, when we reject the null hypothesis, we say the result is statistically significant. Let's try one more intuitive example. Imagine someone claims their coin is fair, that is 50-50 heads and tails. The null hypothesis would be that the coin is fair. Heads and tails are 50-50, or the proportion of heads or tails is 0.5 or 50%. The alternative hypothesis would be that the coin is not fair or the proportion of heads is not 0.5 or 50%. Suppose you flip the coin 100 times. In the first case, you obtain 85 heads. Even without math, you'll think, that's a lot of heads. The probability of getting 85 heads or more, if the coin were truly fair, is extremely small, much less than 0.05. We will then reject the null hypothesis and conclude that the coin is likely not fair. On the other hand, if we obtain 46 heads in 100 tosses, this could easily happen by chance. The probability of getting 46 or fewer heads is high, more than 0.05. We therefore fail to reject the null hypothesis. We say we don't have sufficient evidence to conclude that the coin is unfair. We don't prove that it is fair. We just don't have enough evidence to conclude that the coin is unfair. In summary, hypothesis testing is checking if a claim is believable using data. The claim you test is the null hypothesis. The opposite idea is the alternative hypothesis. You collect a sample to see whether the data fits the claim. You compute a p-value. A low p-value means the data does not fit the claim. You reject the null hypothesis. You say the result is significant. A high p-value means the data fits the claim. You fail to reject the null hypothesis. The result is not significant. And that's it. Thanks for watching.